Hi, this is Viram from Vested. Many Indian investors feel like it's illegal to invest in the US stock market directly. However, that is not true. The RBI has a scheme called the Liberalized Remittance Scheme, or the LRS, that allows Indian investors to legally invest in the international markets. In today's video, we're going to be talking about what this LRS scheme is and the history behind it. So prior to 2004, an Indian resident was actually required to take permission from the RBI every time they sent money abroad. This was originally done by the RBI to prevent excessive outflow of the rupee, which could have destabilized the currency. However, over time, as the world got globalized, the RBI realized that cross-border flow of capital is essential for economic growth. And so that's when in 2004, the RBI introduced the Liberalized Remittance Scheme to simplify the outflow of capital from the country. The Liberalized Remittance Scheme allows Indian residents to freely send money across borders without prior permission from the RBI. However, what the bank did was it ensured that the funds that somebody can send outside stay capped. So in 2013, the cap for an individual transferring funds abroad was $75,000. In 2014, that increased to $125,000. And eventually in 2015, the cap stood at $250,000, which it stands at currently as well. The RBI has appointed the banks to ensure that an individual does not cross this $250,000 limit. Now, under the LRS scheme, the RBI has defined certain purposes that are allowed for Indian residents. For example, sending money for traveling abroad or for studies internationally, or even gifting to your friends or family who might be living outside of the country are all allowed. Similarly, investments in the equity or debt markets abroad are also allowed under the RBI's Liberalized Remittance Scheme. However, what is not allowed is using any earnings that you might have from gambling to remit money internationally. Or you can also not use the money that you've sent abroad for any kind of speculative investments. Now, lastly, let's look at what kind of volumes this LRS scheme has been seeing. Over the last few years, the amount of money sent abroad has increased exponentially. The outflow in financial year 2020 was 19 billion, which is 17 times more than what it was in the financial year 2014. And majority of this outflow is either towards travel or education or gift or towards investments made internationally. So that's it for today's video and the LRS scheme. Keep watching for more.
Thanks for watching. If you like our content, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get regular updates.